magic switch, Isisepi. Now, as the attack or the attacks on our nation's children continue, we have two more stories coming out of, I guess you could say, the usual place then, because more often than not, I've shown you the stats already, you know, say South St. Andrew, right? That general vicinity, usually be a madness go on. This time, let me start off with the case take place at Maxfield, and then we're going to talk about Trenchtown. There's a common denominator between them. Both of them involve Pitney picking up rounds. Now, Maxfield Avenue. Young lady by the name of Tashana Roper. She and I picked them. I get ready for rollout. She's not from the community. Apparently she lives in Denantown. But she passed through the area. She probably thought it was a routine visit, you know. She had nobody in nothing. She had no man in a war, so now the reason for belief, say, you know, watch your head back and you had no man in war, because based on the reports we're getting so far, it's a case of you can't catch Quarko, catch him shut. It's really one of our relatives, them, the man them have a problem with. But, you know, your friendly 87s, you know, your local neighborhood 87s who love and rate so much, realize, oh, man, take away himself. Can't catch man. Oh. Hold on, them relative that. Oh, who that in the car? Who that, hold on, is that a, look like she about 8 and look like the next one about, say 4. I wonder what I should do right now. And guess what your favorite 87 do? Of course, start fire off beer rounds. Nobody's born a pitney. Nobody's born a woman, nobody's born a body. When the smoke clear, Tashana Roper had lost her life. And her 8-year-old daughter ended up pick up rounds, ended up in the hospital. Doctors tried them best, and from what we are here, she's still alive, and it look like, say, she's going to make it. Fortunately, we have to give thanks. Let me say that again. Your favorite 87, the man them who rate, the man them who look up to, idolize, make movie about and sing song about, praising, right, and justifying their actions, because apparently they're so malnourished to have to do things like this. See a woman with them now have nothing personal with. See Pitney, did it, and still never business. The same 87 them only can't bring on a self public condemning. On a favorite woktivist, on a favorite fake revolutionary, fake I love the people, I love the poor, I love the ghetto people, cannot bring themselves to condemn publicly. See, a mother and her two pitting them and light them up. Just through them couldn't get who they really want. No. These are preliminary reports. You know, things like this happen. But we'll compile and then drop a Scud missile upon them. You know, my thing already, my lip on the whole lip, 5 look a small video back now. Compile, and then you see the bomb drop on them, because things like this can go so. Things like this can go so. We cannot have a society where this is so normalized, people just say another one and move on. Them look a girly, see their mother lose her life in front of them, and one of them know what going to feel like. So you can't just go so. I mean, may I have to ask the question, you know? I keep hearing how much people love, protect the women, love the youth, love the children, love ghetto people. And stories like this can fly under the radar and nobody even notice, colonize them about it. Because you don't get woke points for making noise about them cases, eh? You don't get woke social media points for talking about 8-year-old I don't know hospital. Not because they trip and bruise them knee. Right. Or they climb tree and drop out, you know. That's as bad as it should get for 8-year-old. But pick up rounds. No woke points in that thing, yeah. That's your favorite fake woke activist. The business. Until 87s feel shame. You see, the way a bad man is a badge of honor in Jamaica, the way a bad man, you wear that title, people wear it with a sense of pride. Until that title becomes shameful, Jamaica can't change. Until that happens, it can't change. Remember, in Jamaica, killer is a compliment. Think about that. I'm on the diss here and say, you're not killer. That's a diss. You never go in a yard, go shut up, well, your house full of paper. No, exactly. The man said that to you, and I diss him, He's belittling you. You know, it's our culture, this. When you have a country where 5 feet up on a corner, one of them never shot nobody yet, and the other four have, and the other four are mock the one who never shot nobody yet. That's culture. So now that one they want 15 with the other four, so him can't wait for go shot somebody. That's culture. Until the acidity is demonized and have the stigma attached to it like it used to, Jamaica in a serious problem. There was a time in Jamaica when, before me going further, I was watching something, and because I like watch things from around the world to get a perspective of how the rest of the world look on things. And a youth was talking about his family member, and he was saying that when a female relative then carry out an act of criminality, where basically it's so, after them finally saw him, it was so shameful that him end up left and go America. Because the little village where him come from, and him come from, so many Scandinavia where him come from, it was so shameful that him just him pack up and left go America and start a new life, because people like being as the fact that he was even related to the youth there was affecting, I guess, his street cred in the community. People were like, even that, in not, you know, but just by being related to, and the family is so tarnished, and reputation is so tarnished because of that one individually, man take with himself. Why me mention that? There was a time in Jamaica when, if you did have 187 in your family, it was so shameful. There's a time in Jamaica, if you did have two gunman in your family, it was so shameful. All the granny would have disowned him. Granny would have said, me don't know him, you know. Trying to turn 16, me don't know him again. Don't ask me about him, me don't know him. In current Jamaica, if you don't have a gunman in your family, nothing will go on for you. Coming from a bad man family is now a badge of honor. You get ratings. Hold on, Dodo's time uncle, Zeke's time brother, yo, you know, a sci-fi cousin, you know, street cred get boost. Yo, you know, a bigger crime little brother, you know. What? Girl, see them start flock. That's culture. Remember, in an acidic culture, everything is reversed. What do you think when you see the 9-year-old say more than 87? Because MC, them get ratings, and him want ratings. Staying on the subject of Pitney and picking up rooms. Trenchtown, yes, the cultural and the very iconic area Trenchtown produced a lot of greats. Unfortunately, 87 of them decided to set them out continue. For wreak havoc in the place. Because the man them carry out not a double, not a triple, not a quadruple, but a quintuple shooting. 5 people ironically get shot on 5th Street. 5 people get shot on 5th Street. One of them was a child. This is no normal. This is now a daily occurrence. Pitney. I see them do a little protest on a rim and I look, I see Pitney a hold up sign. But I guess, as them say, a child shall lead them. I wonder if we know what's a Trenchtown. If Trenchtown never had the crime, Trenchtown would flourish, you know. When you talk about cultural icon, when you talk about brand, Trenchtown as a brand is very powerful, even on the international stage. If it wasn't for the crime, when you see all kind of tourists and journalists and all kind of people set up camp around and all kind of things that go on. The music and all them things, the Trenchtown is a boom because of the violence. Stagnant. Stagnant for the ordinary Trenchtown citizen. Quintuple shooting. No, one time when you said triple. One time when you said one triple shooting go on, you were like, triple? 3 people one time? It was so mind blowing. Right now that come like 87 that come like 87 that say if you only shoot 3, nothing not go on for you. You think small. Right. You think lame. Quintuple. Wow. So far, if Jamaica make it on a 1500 murders this year, I guess we can light on Kangla and clap on. Because as bad as it sound, that might actually be a decent year considering where we're trending at the moment. If you drop on a 1500. You know you're in problem when that's where the bar is set. Where I said, boy, I hope you get another 1500 cars at least. It's bad, not so bad. That's when you know you're in problem. I'd come like a sprinter, I said, boy, I hope we make it under 14 seconds. That's when you know you're slow. When you aim for 14 seconds, you know you're a slow runner. So whenever a country that they're like, what, make us see we can make it, just be the brush on a 1500, you know. Your country is acidic. Filled with death and destruction. Complete madness. Anyway, for those who are interested, I posted a video on Patreon regarding a new spooky law with the American Medical Association are trying to bring in regarding Pitney. Speaking about Pitney and gender, a few of you might be interested. Check it out if you are. Anyway, Patreon squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know, more life. Vulture squad, stay circling. Bless.